to what Viz says, various events are planned around the UK focusing on the release of a single, a cover version of Rolling Stones' Gimme Shelter, recorded by 12 different artists. It's a bit like Feed the World, except there'll be four records instead of one, and everyone will get to sing the whole thing. Or there'll be four people singing on each record or something like that, which just about explains it, I think.
The actual charity rang my management to ask me for an item of clothing, which is always quite the normal procedure. But I ran out of bras, basically.
Having recently been kicked out of our deal with RCI, we thought maybe we should look after ourselves, because we're very homeless ourselves soon. So I thought maybe we'd best get involved before it was too late.
I mean, we can only do so much, say, as artists, and sort of, you know, big corporates can only do so much with donations, like, you know, some people do, and the great work that some of the soup kitchens do and stuff like that, you know. Not everyday man can do so much, but it's like it's changing people's views.
Yeah, but I mean,
in the house
what this is about is just, you know, making the awareness bigger.
This is quite a special thing for me to get involved with, and that'd be very dear to Keith's heart and to Mick's heart that I'm here doing something for it as well.
We, as entertainers, can do something about it, either with live concerts or making records to help. And with the homeless, it's a thing that has to be sorted out.
Now, again, this is a time to address this issue, because tomorrow's youth, tomorrow's kind of like, tomorrow's country is on the streets.
Kids, so if we can get them to front a campaign which makes sense, which is basically to highlight the problems of the homeless in this country, and we get pop stars saying these things, kids seem to listen to them, understand them, and then look into it further. I think that's basically what we're aiming to do, and what we always did aim to do. I just want to make sure that doesn't get diluted.
But here comes the musical team, keep rocking and singing, so the gardeners keep on coming down, domino plants, so to leave this one, I keep rocking as well the way down there.
What Roger just said was, we're populating itself and we're putting our house in order.
Walking past the repossessed houses.
Set it up, we get the thing rolling, and see how far we could take it. We don't know how far it's going to go in terms of years. We can only at this stage, because there's so much going on, we can see to about May or June, I think. And then we'll be talking about distributing the money, and then we're going to have to sit down and see where we actually go from there, whether it worked and that was it and it's over, or whether we need to do it again and continue it. We can't give an answer at this stage.
We didn't want to do just another charity record, and also to address something that was containable within the confines of the United Kingdom, rather than doing something as general as trying to cure poverty in the whole world, like it might be Ethiopia one year and Somalia or the Sudan the next. This is a domestic problem which we're trying to do something on that basis, to do something concrete about, and trying to achieve something by publicising the issue and attempting to focus people's attention on this rather sad state of affairs.
Well, it can transcend all the different social groups and different, you know, ethnic groups and political groups as well, because it's music, and music tends to do that. You know, all people that make love to the Commodores, don't vote Labour or Conservative particularly, they'll vote for everybody, and the same thing goes for this.
Give me shelter.
Interviews outside, and they say, you know, what do you think is going to come out today? And then I've been answering quite honestly that I think it gets to number one because it has to, because it's just a very clever scam, you know. And if all the 12 different versions go together to make one chart point, then I've been doing radio, you know, I've been radio for like since I was 15, and I think it can't unquestionably get to number one. So, as I say, if you do the same scam with the same bands and record a Pinky and Perky track, that'll also get to number one, but you have the added bonus of this being quite a good song.
Hi, this is Graham Massey from 808 State.
And I'm Robert Owens.
And we've delivered to you our version of
Gimme Shelter.
It was fascinating that just the idea of working with them and then to do a Rolling Stones cover, I was like, well, this is interesting. I like Mick Jagger, so.
I think we're from a generation that don't quite understand what rock classics are, you know.
I had never heard the track, and when I heard it, I was like, oh my god.
It's the REC advert. It's hard to like stereotype, you know, the homeless person these days. You know, once upon a time, you used to think it was like vagrants. And it's very normal people that end up in those situations now, you know.
We are going to make sure that money isn't lost in bureaucracy, it's not lost in administration costs, it just goes into one account, gets accounted for, and then goes back out again. I think an awful lot of charitable concerns, people are very wary because, you know, there is sometimes a large percentage of the money lost through administration, but we're going to make sure there's none of that here.
Hey. I'm Toby.
I'm Mark, we're from the Little Angels.
And we're here to put our house in order. We think it's a really good cause, and it's something that's becoming out of control really in this country, so.
If there's a room that's empty and someone needs to be in that room, put them in it.
You're doing an auction, and which I think all of the bands are getting involved with giving memorabilia, so we're going to try and get some things together. We've got the body of a Telecaster that I smashed up on stage in Milton Keynes when we did the ZZ Top show. We've got...
It itself is homeless, needs a good home,
exactly. And we've got a sweaty pair of leather trousers, perhaps Bruce wore at one gig, that you could don on, put on, and get his scabies and things like that, you know. So if that can help, we'll give it.
Sandy thought she was working with the Cult.
Yeah, we thought we were
it's
getting
a common mistake.
We thought we were getting Dusty, and we got Sandy. She thought she was getting the Cult, and she got Cud. So it's all one big cock up from the start.
In my wildest dreams, I never thought we'd get Hawkwind working with Samantha Fox.
The reason we're involved in this is because it's vitally important that something's done about this situation. There shouldn't be people homeless in this country. There's no reason for it. anyone born in this country has the right to somewhere to live, the right to have food in their belly, the right to survive, to be English, to be part of this country, be accepted as part of it.
This guy, right, he's normally a drummer.
No,
right?
No, I'd never normally sing, you know.
He never sings, and he's... You're the new Phil Collins now, aren't you?
Oh, right, right.
You know all these drummers out there? I mean, the thing is for you, I mean, you sing Frank Sinatra, anything from Frank Sinatra to, what is it?
Well, I'd rather not.
Samantha Fox. I don't think so.
I think people will be talking about the project for quite a long time in the future, basically because we have motivated so many people to do things for themselves. But that will be for us to see. But let's just hope it's in the charts in April and May. And June and July and August and September and whatever comes after that and Christmas.
This is off of one of my favourite all-time Stones albums. So it's great to be, you know, doing another version of it.
Tom Jones at the moment is in Los Angeles, and we'll take the tape over next week and get him to do a vocal.
We can send a camera crew, Tom.
I can't think of anything more strange than Tom Jones working with New Model Army.
The version we've done is very R&B, with the harmonica and everything like that.
Yeah, when I started singing in Wales, I worked with a small band. Three guitars and drums, you know, that was it. So I did a lot more rock, R&B type stuff in those days, so that's where my roots are anyway. So for me to do a song like this is not difficult. I don't have to rethink, I just have to do it the way I know.
Well, this is Shepherd's Bush Green in the heart of London, and it's a Saturday afternoon, beautiful sunny, and we're making a video with Tom Jones. And hopefully we can cause a bit of a stir, have a few people around, advertise it and all that.
Hello, I'm Loz from Kingmaker, and I've just finished mixing our version of Gimme Shelter. It's great. so much of it was the characters in the band that made the track that we had to just hope that our personalities would be enough to make the track live as Kingmaker, really.
It must have been especially hard for you, because like, when you wrote it...
Yeah, that was difficult.
You know, you must have realised at the time you'd written a classic.
In power at the time, be it the Tories or the Labour Party, they really should look at the problems of homelessness and definitely sort it out.
Whatever I would do in my room, I should do here.
This house is everybody's house. That's what it stands for. So every room in this house is what's going on in houses up and down the country. And what's going outside with poor Jimmy in the alleyway is what's going on outside. And everybody inside is ignoring outside.
Get the other drawer. We like the drawers. Willie? Yeah. I take it you're shooting the verses separately, yes.
No, I'm going to shoot them as is. This is the verse where you go,
and then
threatening my very life today. And you kind of like, almost kind of like, because the way you sing it, it's like, you know, it is threatening, yes. And then
he's kind of going,
because you're kind of cat low in that. He's kind of going, give me this. And you're going, I'm going to fade away.
Right. Playback and turnover.
Hello.
We're Thunder.
And we are
helping to put our house in order.
You know, it's a world recession. There isn't much money around, and people like us are fortunate enough to generate, you know, large amounts of money, and if that's so, then it doesn't hurt us to, you know,
divert a little.
Or bands have been involved in charity stuff before. It's been like an international charity like Live Aid or Somalia or something like that. And this is, you know, although there are homeless people all over the world, it's really, really a domestic issue. EMI contacted us and we said, yeah, sure, you know, we'd love to be involved. Plus, it's my favourite Stones song, so that's another good reason for doing it.
Hopefully lots of press will be forthcoming.
He's actually had a H, a homeless, put on the side of his head there. Look at that, free advertising that is.
I think one thing we have retained right the way along the way with this project is we have retained credibility. Whereas we're not releasing a racket, we're not aiming to make just lots of money. We are aiming to make a very strong statement about homelessness to the country.
We haven't worked together for 6 years, Heaven 17 that is. Quite a long time, I think you'll agree. Considering that we're having a lot of top 40 hits now, time seems to be running backwards, in fact, I'd say. And so we thought it'd be fun to record together again, just like the old days.
And how wrong he was. It's been awful.
And cue. The flood is threatening. Am I very light today? Give me shelter. Or I'm gonna fade away.
This, I think, is a very good cause, and it's not like a big, it's not a big deal, is it? It's not like
exactly.
We're doing a world tour or anything, you know. It's like just a bit of fun. Really.
What? There's no world tour.
No.
Oh, bummer.
And even worse, they're not paying us for it.
No, hospitality means, Mark.
Oh, is it? Oh, right.
Cut. Sister, it's just a kiss away.
I remember the very first time we ever went to New York, and we were astonished to find people like lying in doorways.
That's right, yeah.
And now, where are we now?
I know that the organisers are in a difficult position in many ways, because out of this is going to come a glossy single, and a glossy CD, and it's all going to seem very showbiz. But there's nothing wrong with that either, you know? So, and it, whatever it takes to get it to number one, really. And also, I think the funniest thing of all of it, and this is what I really want to see, is if it stays at number one for a few weeks, you know, Whitney Houston or Bryan Adams standard, then I want to see each different band, every week on Top of the Pops. That would be fantastic, you know. I mean, you know, if the BBC are thinking of acting Top of the Pops now, just let it run for 12 more weeks so we can see all the 12 bands, that's all.
I'm Durga McBroom from Blue Pearl. I've been doing some work with the Utah Saints, and this is our version of Gimme Shelter.
The kind of society we live in relies on pressure groups to actually get up there and make a big fuss in order to change things. And what we're trying to do with the means at our disposal is to make a very big fuss about an important issue.
It's something that I think is easily neglected and looked over because a lot of these people don't actually seem to have either representation. A lot of people are disenfranchised, and there isn't particularly a lobby for the homeless as such. It's not a strong issue at the moment. I think that it's something that I feel has been overlooked by people in general. We're just trying to publicise the fact and bring a bit of attention onto the subject. Kiss away, kiss away.